Hi, this is Fred. We're going to show you how to set up audio in BigBlueButton. This video will cover four topics, the type of headsets you can buy, connecting them to your computer, checking that they work, and joining audio in BigBlueButton. This is a typical headset you can buy. It has an arm for the microphone to come out by your mouth. It also has on the cord a volume control. If yours has one, make sure you turn it up, otherwise you won't hear. And this headset has the two jacks, one for microphone, one for headset. We'll show plugging them in later. Here's another type of headset. Again, the top part looks very similar, the earphones with the microphone. This particular headset, though, is a USB headset. So it plugs into the USB port. We'll show it in a moment. It also has a volume control, but it also has a hardware mute. So you want to make sure it's on, otherwise no one can hear you. Here's a third type of headset. The difference here is it has a single plug for both microphone and speaker, and this plugs into the newer laptops that you would find. A variation of the single plug is the earbuds, volume control, a microphone, and also a single plug for your computer. Okay, you probably have one of those four types of headsets. Let's show connecting them to your computer. I have a MacBook Air here. It has a single jack for a microphone, and it also has a USB, so I could use either the USB or the single plug. Here's a USB, just plug it into the USB port. That's it, very straightforward. If you have the single plug, again, it's very easy. Just plug it in, you're done. If you have an older laptop with two plugs or even three, you're gonna wanna make sure that you line it up with the right jacks. So here, you can see on the plug, the microphone icon. Here, I'm gonna plug it into the microphone jack. It has this icon right next to the jack. And I'll also plug the speaker one into the next closest jack. Most laptops will only have two jacks. This one has three. If I flip it back over, it's good to go. If you have a desktop, you usually find the plugs sometimes are on the top of the computer. Again, make sure you line up. Headset into the headset jack. Microphone into the microphone jack. Another variation is the plugs are on the front. Again, just line up the icons, headset, and the headset jack, and the microphone, and the microphone jack. The last variation is that plugs may be in the back of your computer. This way it's easiest to actually do it by color. The green plug in the green, and the microphone in the microphone port. Now we'll check that the microphones actually work. We can do this in the operating system. On Windows 8, click Desktop, and then right-click on the speaker icon in the lower right-hand corner and choose Recording Devices. On Windows 7, it's the same. Just right-click on the speaker icon and choose Recording Devices. The recording devices will let us see what active microphones we have. So right now, it's using the webcam, but that's not what we want to use. So to show you what happens when you plug in the microphone with a dialog box open, I'm going to plug them in now, and you'll notice that Windows switches it to the default microphone. That's what you want. And you also want to make sure that the audio is coming through your microphone. Easiest way to do is just tap it. If Windows has chosen the wrong default microphone when you're tapping, you can switch it by just selecting it and then click Set Default. This will now make it the default microphone, which is what you want. Let's now show testing the microphone on the Mac. In the upper hand corner, click on the magnifying glass, enter a few letters of the word system, and choose System Preferences. Click the sound control, and then click the input tab. This will show us the input microphones, and now it's the default, but here I'm going to plug in a microphone and you'll see a change. Now shows a microphone port, and again we can test that it's working by just tapping on the microphone itself. Now that we plug the microphone in and check that it works, let's now join BigBlueButton. We'll do it first through Chrome. This is the same on Windows or Mac. Click the headset icon if you don't already see the audio chooser, and click Microphone. This will trigger Chrome to ask for permission. You need to give it permission by clicking Allow. Once you click Allow, BigBlueButton will make a connection and it will start the audio. It takes about 5 to 8 seconds to connect. Once it's connected, you'll get a chance to test your microphone. You should hear yourself in your headset when you talk a few words. Click Yes to join. And then again, it'll take about 5 to 8 seconds, and then it will join you into the audio. At this point, you have a functioning microphone and others in the class should be able to hear you. Also, when you talk, your microphone will highlight. And you can mute and unmute yourself just by clicking the mute unmute button in the toolbar. Okay, let's now join through Firefox. It's going to be very similar. Firefox has a slightly different permissions for the microphone. If you don't see the microphone choice, click the headset icon and then click microphone. Firefox will prompt for permission, but unlike Chrome, if you click elsewhere, the permissions dialog box will actually go away. Don't worry, just you can get it back by clicking the microphone icon in the toolbar. Once you see it, click share selected device. And as before, BigBlueButton will connect to the audio bridge. It will bring you into a session where you can hear yourself in your headset. It's an echo test. Just speak a few words, and if you hear yourself, click yes. BigBlueButton will now join you into the audio with all the other students in the class, and you'll be able to see your microphone highlight when you talk. And as before, you can always mute and unmute yourself by clicking the mute button in the title bar. So let's just leave the audio and join again, and we'll show you what happens if you said no, you couldn't hear yourself. So again, we'll choose a microphone. BigBlueButton will connect. And in the echo test, let's say we said no, we don't hear ourselves. It will actually drop back to using Flash. And in Flash, it'll actually give you the choice of microphones and an energy bar showing you if the microphone you've chosen is active. You can test the speakers. And when you have an active microphone, click Next. And as before, you're in the echo test, and if you want to join, you can click Yes. And now you're in the audio bridge again. Finally, if you want to just reset BigBlueButton and start over, you don't have to log in or log out. You can just click the refresh button on your browser toolbar. It will launch BigBlueButton again, and you can click Microphone to join. That's an overview of setting up audio in BigBlueButton.